You know, every once in a while, a movie comes along that feels like it could have been something that I watched way back in the late 70s or early 80s. Odd Thomas is a 2013 movie that could just as easily have been made a few decades ago. Based on Dean Koontz's novel of the same name, the movie's directed, written, and co-produced by Stephen Sommers and stars Anton Yelchin, doing his best to channel a young Michael J. Fox as Odd Thomas, with Willem Dafoe doing what Willem Dafoe does best as Sheriff Wyatt Porter, and Addison Timlin stepping into Phoebe Cates' mode as Stormy Llewellyn. Yelchin, you may remember, has been part of the recent Star Trek movie reboots, playing Lieutenant Chekhov. Unfortunately, a few years ago, he passed away due to a freak accident with his own Jeep. This movie, as well as the two Star Trek features, really allow us to see an actor at the top of his game with tons of on-screen charm and charisma. What? You say you've never heard of this movie? That's because it was never released in theaters. Your best bet for this one is Netflix or renting it through one of the other streaming services. Now, I know that direct-to-video usually means that the movie isn't up to the standards of films that you go out and pay money for. But wait, this one is different. The movie wasn't released in theaters because of a couple of different legal entanglements that dragged it down and ultimately made it impossible to move forward with a multi-million-dollar marketing campaign. End of the day, those involved just dumped it on video without any sort of promotion and hoped for the best. And I've got to say, it's a shame there wasn't more promotion, that more people haven't seen this little gem of a film. The plot reminds me a little bit of an old Peter Jackson film, which, by the way, starred Michael J. Fox, called The Frighteners. In both movies, the main character can see the dead. Odd, right? Well, that's why he's called Odd Thomas. And yes, that is his real name in the movie. So anyway, Odd does what he can to assist the dead in righting whatever wrongs are keeping them in this realm and halting them from moving forward to the afterlife. Odd's best friend is Stormy. They've been friends since childhood, and their bond is unbreakable. Odd can also see these death-seeking creatures called Bodaks. Whenever he spots one, he knows that death and tragedy, well, they're close by. The plot has something to do with plan to create unspeakable chaos, mayhem, and misery in Odd's sleepy little town. Odd knows that something big is up because of the large number of Bodaks that are gathering. So what works? Well, the story is the stuff that paperbacks are made of. Dean Koontz, the author of the Odd Thomas novels, has created a world where everything seems familiar. The movie riffs off of a lot of other movies, and you'll know them when you see them. Call it an homage, not a rip-off, because the movie is all the better for them, and it gives you this sense of comfortableness. It just lulls you into a feeling of calm right before it throws a big scare at you. Yelchin is great. He's such a tragedy that he'll not be around to make more movies. He will be missed. What doesn't work? Well, there's a plot twist that many of you will see a mile away. Just remember, it's an homage, not a rip-off. So, end of the day, this is a movie that I expected very little from. But it's lightweight and fun, a perfect way to spend 97 minutes. Trust me, when it's over and you see Odd Thomas nearing the city of Las Vegas, you'll yearn for a sequel, for a chance to go back and spend more time with him. And fortunately for us, while we can't do it on the silver screen, we can do it through Koontz's novels. There's a bunch of them. So that's it. Have you seen this film? If so, let me know what you think in the comments section below. And while you're at it, I would love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and I would be absolutely honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. Always the good stuff. But most importantly, thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video.